Hi, in my next part of my mini-series about authentication and authorization, I want to talk about the pluggable auth service in Plone. If we look into the ZMI, the pluggable authentication service can be found here under ACL users. In fact, this object we are now in, ACL users, is an instance of the pluggable auth service. It contains several other objects related to the pluggable auth service, and it's called pluggable because all this additional stuff you see in here are plugins that have different functions in the pluggable auth service. Important to know is that the pluggable auth service is stacked or inherits also the authentications from its parent. And the parent is at the SOAP root. There's also an ACL users, and in here are also plugins. But as you can see, the folder here, the pluggable auth service here, is not as filled up with plugins as the one in Plone. So going back to the Plone one, and let's have a look here. This is the plugin registry. The plugin registry, all plugins are registered and you can activate and deactivate plugins here. The main groups of plugins we have are first the extraction plugins, which are used to get the user data out of the request, like username and password from a form or the username and password from an encrypted cookie or the web token used like JWT or something like that. Then we have authentication plugins, which are used for the authentication check if the username and the password are okay against the database or something like that. Then we have user factories, which are creating the user object after the authentication plugin tells us that the credentials were okay. We have the same for group factories, which create group objects connected to the users. We have property plugins, and property plugins are responsible to get the user data from some database and add the user data as a property sheet or a series of property sheets to the user, and the same for groups, which also can have properties. Then we have roles plugins, which are responsible to add roles to groups and users and get also the roles in context later on. And then we have some helpers to add and update users and groups, and also plugins to introspect users and groups and roles in order to get information to display on the screen, like lists of groups, lists of users, and so on. There are some other plugins as well, but that are the important groups. So you can scroll down here, you can do it on your own if you like, and read what the plugins are doing. And as an example, I take the extraction plugins, and here you can see which plugins are available. So all available plugins are active plugins here, and I have a credential cookie auth, which means that the information is extracted from a cookie. It's a credential basic auth, which means that the information is extracted from the header as a basic authentication, and we have a session authentication. Order is important here as well. This means that first the credential cookie auth is checked, and then this basic auth, and then the session authentication. And the same is valid, for instance, for the properties plugins, where we have the mutable property plugins and an auto group plugin. But now imagine we have users in the ZODB and users from an LDAP server in here. So we have two types of plugins, a mutable properties plugin for the ZODB and an LDAP properties plugin. And now if I ask for some value, I read like the LDAP plugin is the first one. I ask the LDAP plugin, give me this and that property, and the LDAP plugin say, yes, I have it, great. And then you have the same stored in the mutable properties, and LDAP wins. And if not, it looks in the mutable properties. But now we have two different kinds of, we have mutable property access and read-only property access, and LDAP is a read-only access, for instance, and now I store a property, and then the LDAP plugin is not available as a plugin for storing properties, then the properties are stored in the mutable property plugin. And so order matters because I can store this property, but it would never be read again because LDAP has probably the same property already available. And therefore the mutable properties plugin had to be the first one, then the LDAP second, to make it work to store properties in ZODB and have them defaults from LDAP. If you don't want it at all, then put LDAP first. Things like that are possible. And as you can imagine, you can write your own plugin for sure. It's a more complex task, but possible. Or you can just take one of the existing plugins. And there's a bunch of plugins available. Let's have a look at that. So there's no good page with a list of all pass plugins available. But we can use a namespace search for projects on PyPI and use pass.plugins namespace, which are lots of plugins are using. And as you can see here, you get some results, but be aware that some are outdated. So really look at the descriptions, the release dates, the supported clone versions, and so on. There are some rock stars around: pass plugins headers, pass plugins LDAP, pass plugins SQL Alchemy are all very useful. And some special plugins like pass plugins member property to group, which has a special use case, and so on. If you look at some of these plugins, they are very different. Pass plugin SQL Alchemy is more or less a basic implementation to plug in some database, but you really need to a lot of configuration and setup and to get it work. Then we have simpler plugins like pass plugins headers, which can be configured very easily and installed also very easily. So depending on your use case and where your users are located, you need different plugins. If you have a SQL database, plus plugin SQL Alchemy helps you to get everything set. If you have a SAML authentication which is resolved in front of your clone, like in Apache or Nginx, pass plugins headers is the way to go. And if you have an LDAP server, then probably you want to use pass plugins LDAP to get all your users into clone. So thanks for watching. This was a quick overview about pass. In my next talk, I will go more into depth with LDAP in clone using pass plugins LDAP.